This video explains an inbuilt NetSim example for simulating and studying TCP connection establishment and termination. We are using NetSim standard version 12.1. Open NetSim and click Examples, Experiments, Introduction to TCP Connection Management Sample 1. This loads the saved scenario. There are two nodes, one is the source and the other is the destination. When an application process in a particular host seeks a reliable data connection with a process in another host, it proceeds to establish a TCP connection at both the ends. In our sample, we set up a simple FTP or file transfer application between the source wired node 1 and destination wired node 2. Transport protocol parameter in the application properties is set to TCP by default. We are going to utilize the inbuilt Wireshark interfacing capability of NetSim to capture and study the TCP packets. In the general properties of wired node 1, the Wireshark option is set as online. The link properties are set, such that uplink and downlink speed for all three links are set to 10 Mbps each. The link bit error rate is set as 0. The propagation delay in the links between the nodes and the routers is set to 100 microseconds, and the propagation delay for the link between the two routers is set as 50,000 microseconds. In the application properties, the file size and file inter arrival time are set to 14,600 bytes and 10 seconds respectively. Now, we run the simulation for 10 seconds. Once the simulation begins, you can notice that a Wireshark PCAP file is generated along with the simulation. Now scroll to the beginning of the timeline to view the connection establishment between source and the destination. First, the source sends a special TCP segment called the SYN packet to the destination. Then, upon receiving the SYN packet at the other end, it proceeds with the allocation of TCP buffer and variables to the connection. Also, a TCP connection granted segment called the SYNACK packet is sent back to the source by the destination. Finally, upon receiving the SYNACK segment, the source allocates the TCP buffer and variables to the connection and acknowledges the connection granted segment with an ACK of its own. This connection establishment procedure is often referred to as the three-way handshake. The TCP connection is uniquely identified by the source and destination port numbers exchanged during TCP connection establishment, and the source and destination IP addresses. We can also access the packet header details of the TCP segments in Wireshark from the packet information provided. The same can be visualized using the NetSim animation window. Click on play button. Notice that TCP three-way handshake happens initially by transmitting a SYN, followed by a SYNACK, and then by an ACK. Once a TCP connection is established, the application process at the source sends the data to the destination. Now let us look at connection termination. The TCP connection can be terminated by either of the two processes. Suppose that the source seeks to terminate the connection. The connection termination happens this way. First, the source sends a special TCP segment called the FIN packet to the destination. Then, upon receiving the FIN packet at the other end, the receiver sends an acknowledgement ACK segment in return and its own FIN segment to terminate the full duplex connection. Finally, upon receiving the FIN ACK segment, it proceeds with deallocation of all the TCP resources at both the ends and acknowledges the connection close segment with an ACK of its own. The same can be visualized in the NetSim animation window. The TCP connection teardown process starts by the source process sending a FIN packet to the destination, followed by a FIN ACK, and then by an ACK. This ends up the connection between the client and the server. Thank you for watching.